Good morning. My name is Mike, and today we're going to take a look at this beautiful Lenovo Y50-something. I think it's a 7 or a 70. And it is a i7-4700. They say it's a gaming PC. I think that might be stretching it a bit. It is, well, it might have been a gaming PC at one point when it came out. I think it came out around 2014. i7-4700. HQ at 2.4 gigahertz with 8 threads. It's got an HD graphics 4600, even though down here it says it has the GeForce GTX something. 2 gigs of RAM for the video card, 8 gigs of RAM inside it, though I might bump that up to 16 gigs when we take it apart. It did come with a 1 terabyte drive that was a hybrid between an SSD and a regular spindle. I don't particularly like those drives because the SSD partition is really small. So I put in a 512 gig SSD. And it's currently running Ubuntu 21.10. And I think it's running pretty smooth. Oh, and did I mention it's also a touchscreen? So there you go. Anyway, let's take a closer look at this and we'll start by going around the edge. Okay, before I do the walk around on this, there's something I really need to point out quickly, and that's the keyboard layout. As you can see here, you got the return key, well, enter, I don't know why they don't call it return, but right up here, whenever I'm hitting the backspace key, I find that I'm often hitting the num lock and it's not doing anything. The keyboard itself is quite comfortable, it's just that I find the layout between the number pad and the keyboard is just not quite wide enough. I'd rather have just a bit more of a gap. If they could have just gave it like a millimeter or two on either side and just put me a bit more room right there. Because, I mean, look at how close those are. Anyway, you know, you can't expect perfection. Okay, let's do the walk around on this. Okay, let's start on the front. So over here we have power, charging, not sure what this is, and that is your hard drive light. So there's four lights right there. It's a little dented, actually. Didn't realize that. Cruising along, there's nothing over here. So on this side, there's nothing over here. And I really don't know what this one here is. That's your headphone microphone. That's your SD card reader. This here's a USB. And that there is your lock. This looks like a speaker, but I don't think that actually is a speaker. On the back, I believe that these might be speakers. Nothing over here. Another grate or a speaker, it's hard to say. We have another artistic touch here. There we have your power. Here we have a network port, full-size HDMI, and a couple more USBs. Right there, we've got nothing except for a bit of a dent and some scratches. You know, it's a good thing this thing is metal because the scratch is pretty easy. On the bottom, we have this large ventilation area with more dents and a subwoofer right there and a Windows 8 sticker. Two rubber feet here, big long rubber foot there. All in all, it's not a bad looking machine. I mean, it feels pretty high grade. And man, this thing is heavy. This is one big machine. There's a scratch down there that I tried to cover up with a black marker. Didn't quite go the way I wanted it to, but it does have this nice brushed aluminum look. Plus the Lenovo logo up there. It would have been really nice if that Lenovo logo would have had just a slight red outline, but that's my two cents. Okay, let's get into the rest of this. Now, a quick little side note on the adapter. It does require 170 watt, so this is actually 20 volt, 8.5 amp. This is a bit heftier than some of the other Lenovo chargers that you're going to come across. This beast draws a lot of power. That's all we have to say on that. Okay, let's take this apart really quick. But first off, I've said this 1,000 times, invest in a good screwdriver set. Just because you don't want to strip any of these screws, it is a right royal pain in the ash. I'll leave the link below for this in Amazon. If you click on it, I get a little bit of the pie. I do appreciate your time and effort. But now let's hopefully pull this apart without too many issues. Got my little jar here. There are, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I think those two will stay on there. There's a bit of a crack in this corner down here. So who knows what's going to happen with it. But we'll start up here. I'll probably just end up fast-forwarding this. This little T on here that makes it look like a cross, that's just if you need torque. You probably don't need it today. Now, like I said, I already changed out the hard drive in here. I put in an SSD. And I think, I tell you, it's tempting that I might even keep this machine just because I really like it so much. It's got a lot more oomph than I thought it did. I mean, for a quad-core 4th-gen processor. And it runs Ubuntu really well. So far, I haven't had any issues at all with that. See, here we go. This is where I'm stripping them a little. And that's why you want a good screwdriver set. Because if you get something with cheap metal down here, all it's going to do is just, the cheap metal will strip the screw.
A few moments later.
Oh my goodness. You'd think that after doing this for so many years, this would be a lot easier. I just don't want to break anything. Christ. Snap. That sounded, yep, see the screw came right through there. So maybe these screws are meant to come out. My mistake is your learning opportunity. That one's already off, so. Well, nothing that some duct tape can't fix. Am I right? Am I right? That screw's not coming out at all. Yeah, I guess those are supposed to come out. See it there? And then here? That's the crack I was talking about. There's a screw inside of it. God, what a pain in it. Like, this is such a piss-poor design when you mix plastic with metal. So that's metal. That's plastic. Jesus Christ. And now there's a piece of plastic stuck to this. Okay. See what I did there? And they're breaking the plastic around it. Don't do what I did. All right, so looking at this, we have, there's the crucial hard drive I put in there. Here's the battery. There's the two sticks of RAM. Each one is 4 gigs. So if we got 2 sticks of 4 gigs RAM. And yeah, I think I might pop those out and put in 16 gigs if it will actually hold it. All right, so RAM, hard drive. Hard drive's held in with these two little screws here. One there. Battery goes to here. Don't know what that is. There's your fan. I heard the fan's making like a grabbing sound earlier. That's your subwoofer. So over here we have a USB. There's your HDMI. 2 more USB. That's your network port. There's your Kensington lock. Almost looks like an eSATA, but that's your USB SD card reader, headphone microphone, whatever the hell that other thing is. And I should also change out this battery, because this battery is absolute garbage. Let's see if we can zoom in there so you can see what it is. So as you can see here, this is rechargeable lithium polymer battery, model L13M4P02, 7.4 volt, 54 watt hours, 7400 milliamps. But that's basically it in a nutshell. So here's your two cooling tubes that come out to here. There's your two fans. And here's your stupid hinges. There. And there. All right. Let's change that RAM out really quick. Okay. We are back. I got the RAM out. Now, first thing I do before I put the bottom back on, I'm going to turn it on really quick just to make sure that it registers the 16 gigs of RAM, because there's no sense me putting all this back together. Now, these are the same, I believe. As you can see, these are 8 gig DDR3 12800S. So they should work. So first things first. Let's turn this over and just power it on really quick. I'm just putting the bottom on there so that we don't get any shocks. I'll put a camera over here so you can watch it boot with me. Okay, 3, 2, 1. Let's see if this thing even turns on. Well, that's a good sign. It's powering on anyway. Ah, good sign. That's always a bit of a bonus, isn't it? It's not going straight to BIOS to give me any kind of errors, so that's good. We'll go into settings really quick. God, touchscreens are just so awesome. 15.5 gigs of RAM. All right, that's a good thing. All right, let's finish this and put this all back together. Okay, a few final thoughts on it. I mean, like I said, it's running Ubuntu 21.10 with no issues. A few things I do like. I like the touchscreen. Seems to work really well. And you'll see here, I don't mind the camera so much. Let's just make this a little bit bigger, if I can. I guess I can go full screen. And that's not too bad. I'm a little washed out, but I think that's because of the light up here. It's got a little light on the camera up there. It's got that stabilization going on in the screen. That's why it looks like I'm wobbling, but in reality, the camera's trying to stabilize itself. Besides the issue with the keyboard, I think the numlock, I would have liked it if it was moved over a little bit. That would have made a big difference. Cost-wise, well, I paid $150 Canadian for this. It did not come with the charger. You will need to get a charger. This charger cost me $25. The RAM cost me $150. So if my and the SSD, that was $25. So my initial cost of $150 is now $250 with those accessories added to it. Now, $250, I think, is about the limit of what I'd want to pay for this complete. I think that if I were to sell this, I might be able to get between $250 to $400. We'll take a look at some eBay listings here. As you can see, they're all over the map when it comes to pricing. And it all depends on what kind of condition they're in as well, too. This is a 7-year-old laptop. Yeah, 7 years. So it's got a bit of wear and tear on it. I mean, I've always said that used laptops are a lot like used cars. And what happens is that people start modding them, or they just don't take care of them. They don't service them, so they slowly die. That's it, though. I mean, all in all, I'm really up in the air if I'm going to keep this or not. It plays the games I want to play, which are MAME arcade games, because I'm old school like that. I have installed Steam on here, and my kid plays a couple games on it, but, you know, we'll save that for another video. So, if you like these kind of videos, please hit that subscribe button, hit the like, you know, drop a comment down below if you have any anything interesting to say about it. And that is that. Remember, there's no computer like an old computer. So, thanks for spending your time with me. Hopefully we'll talk soon.